Hey guys, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how I created this makeup look right here. Honey, let me just tell you right now, I'm obsessed. I know I say that about every makeup look that I do, but you guys, I'm not usually one to blow out my eyeshadow so far. I really do like the way it looks. I feel like it really gives you like a beautiful like cat eye effect. So I'm super excited to show you guys how I created this look. So I'm not using any new eyeshadows in today's makeup look. We're just using a few shadow palettes in my collection. I did want to mention though, I did use quite a few palettes. So I did dip into the Be Perfect Carnival 3 Love Tahiti palette. You guys, this is one of my favorite eyeshadow palettes. I swear, you guys, my dog really does talk. Like, this is one of my favorite eyeshadow palettes that I own in my collection. So this is the Be Perfect Carnival 3 Love Tahiti palette with Stacy Marie. This is one of my favorite eyeshadow palettes that I have in my collection, you guys. I am obsessed with this palette, and I haven't used it in a hot minute. I've been using a ton of newer eyeshadow palettes on my channel, so I wanted to dip into this baby. How gorgeous is this palette, you guys? I do have a ton of tutorials using this palette, as well as the Carnival XL Pro palette, which I love as well. So we're going to be using that today. I also did use only one eyeshadow out of the Glam Light. This is their Ice Cream Dream palette. This palette is so beautiful, you guys. It is so gorgeous. I actually did a look with this palette and I ended up losing the footage and I was so devastated, but I did want to use one of the shades in here as well because I wanted more of a warm tone brown. But this is what this palette looks like. It is so gorgeous. It's such a pastel dream. I'm obsessed. The shimmers in here are freaking gorgeous. For my inner corner, you guys can see, girl, you can't tell me you can't see that bright white inner corner. Honey, you already know my favorite white eyeshadow of all time is from the Anastasia Riviera palette, and it is the shade Sails, which is this color right over here. As you guys can see, she gets a lot of love. I have four of these eyeshadow palettes in my collection, and girl, I bought all four of them just to have that white eyeshadow because I'm pretty sure they don't make this palette anymore. If they do, I will link it down below so you guys can get your hands on it because it is worth the money. Even just for that white eyeshadow, and it's also always on sale. I have three other ones in my collection that I actually found at a TJ Maxx, so definitely look for this palette if you guys go into a TJ Maxx. It is amazing. But as far as new products, we are using new products in today's video. I'm going to be testing out the One Size. This is their Ultimate Setting Powder, and this is what the packaging looks like. I love the packaging. I did mention that I was obsessed with the packaging in my Sephora haul. If you guys have not seen my Sephora haul, I will go ahead and put it in the iCards above and I'll link it down below so you guys can check it out. But in that video, I did ask you guys what you wanted to see me use, and a lot of you guys said the Naughty Nude palette from Huda Beauty, which I did do a video on already, and you guys also said the One Size powder from Patrick Star. So we're going to be using that in today's video. I also did test out this Gucci bronzer that I picked up during the sale as well. Bougie, but honey, let me tell you, she's very cute. You guys will see it in action in the video. And then really quickly before we jump into today's video, I wanted to mention my gloss. You guys, how beautiful is this lip gloss? I am obsessed. So I also got this during the Sephora sale. This is the Artist Couture Gloss in Uncensored 2.0. This is what it looks like right here. It is so gorgeous. Okay, it is the perfect nude gloss. I'm obsessed. It does have like a cooling sensation, which I was not expecting at all, but I honestly don't mind it. It feels really, really nice on the lip. So between this one and the Morphe Madison Beer Mercury Lip Gloss, these have been my go-to. Like, I'm obsessed. Other than that, that's basically it. I really hope you guys enjoy this makeup look. Let me know what you guys think of it down below. So before we jump into today's video, please don't forget to give this video a huge thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, girl. It is 100% free, honey. Hit that subscribe button, and right next to the subscribe button, definitely turn on your post notification. That way you guys can get notified every single time I post a new video. And of course, as always, if you guys would like to see how I created this makeup look today, then just keep on watching. Jumping straight into today's look, I'm going to be using my P. Louise base in the shade Rumor Number 2. This base is crucial
especially when it comes to me doing a colorful eyeshadow look, you guys. This is like a necessity for me. I don't know what's in this base, but some way, somehow, it just makes my colors look so much more vibrant, and I just love it. It is a tacky base as well, so it will adhere to your shadows and, like I said, make them look super pigmented. So I do go ahead and dot it all over the lid and then just pat it in with a small buffing brush. So moving into the Be Perfect Carnival 3 palette, this is the Love Tahiti palette. I'm going to be going into the shade Cocoa, which is that beautiful, deep, but warm brown. And just like I start all my looks, I'm going to start this look the same. I'm basically taking a small Morphe brush and I'm just packing that shade right into the crease and kind of like building the shape exactly how I want it. This is basically going to be like my guideline, if you will, because we're going to pack on color in the same shape that this is, if that makes sense. So I find this to be super easy in my opinion. Then I'm going to go into the shade Ginger, which is at the bottom of the palette, and I'm basically just going to use this eyeshadow to help blend out the shade Cocoa. That way everything looks seamless and everything looks nice and blended and very diffused. That's always the look that I go for. And then now I'm going to go into the shade called Mango. This is such a beautiful, vibrant orange, you guys. It is gorgeous. I mean, this entire palette is beautiful, but this one specifically is just stunning. I have never seen a shade like this before, and I have quite a few shadow palettes. So I'm taking this on a big, fluffy yet tiny brush, if that makes sense. Like, this brush is very flared out, and I'm just packing that on. And then I'm also going to go into the shade Sand, which is an even lighter orange. So you guys can kind of see like the method that I'm doing. So I'm basically building from darkest to lightest up to the brow bone, and just having those shades in different kind of tones, if that makes sense, like some lighter, some darker. You're really gonna get that really, really beautiful blend that we all want, right? We don't want no harsh lines over here. So now I'm gonna go in to the shade called Chili Pepper. This is a really beautiful deep red shade, and I'm actually gonna use this on a really tiny precise blending brush. I'm actually gonna leave all the brushes that I used in today's look down below in the description box in case you guys are interested. And basically what I'm gonna do with this is pack this color into the actual crease. So I don't know if you guys can tell, but doing all those extra steps made it so easy to put your darker color because everything looks so nice and blended. So jumping into the Glam Light Ice Cream Dream palette, you guys, this palette is so beautiful. I'm gonna be dipping into the shade called Chocolate. I needed a darker brown, and unfortunately the Love Tahiti palette does not have a deep enough brown to give me the depth that I was looking for in today's eye look. So I did just dip into this palette. It is so beautiful, and it was the perfect shade of brown. So I just packed that right into the crease to help define everything, make it look more intense. And then jumping back in to the Tahiti palette, I'm going to be using the shade Yellow, and I'm going to take this on that same like tiny but fluffy brush, and I'm going to put this over those orange colors, and this is really going to give us that really beautiful blown out effect and that really nice ombre effect, and everything is just going to blend really well together because we're basically using the same tones just with different undertones, if that makes sense. So that's all I did with that, and then I went back into the shade Chili Pepper just to make sure that everything looked nice and diffused. There was a little bit of a gap between the oranges and that really deep red, so I definitely wanted to make sure that everything kind of just blended into one another. So that's what I'm doing there. And then we're going to start on the cut crease. So I'm just taking a Q-tip with some micellar water, and I'm basically just cleaning up that lid space. So not only is this going to give you the cleanest cut crease, but it's also going to give you a guideline. So it's also the easiest cut crease. So I highly recommend you trying it this way. Super simple and easy. And to actually cut the crease, I'm using the P. Louise base and Mitchell. This is the base in a blank canvas. It is a must for me. And I did my cut crease off camera because, honey, when I tell you I can spend like 30 minutes on my cut crease, it's ridiculous. As you guys can see, after 30 minutes, it still wasn't as perfect as I wanted. So I went back in and perfected it. And most of the time, I do go in with that same tiny buffing brush just to make sure everything is patted out and it's as smooth as possible, because this base is very, very thick. So if you leave too much on your eyelid, it's going to completely mess up your shadow and get all cracky and cakey, and it's a mess. So moving into the Pure Raw Beauty Christie palette, you guys, I know I'm using so many eyeshadows in today's look, I apologize, but I'm taking that really pretty kind of like cream color, and this shade is literally the same shade as Blank Canvas, and it was perfect because I just wanted to set the base but not change the color. So now jumping into the outer part of the eye, I'm going to start off with those orange shades. So I took a mixture of Mango and Sundown, and I'm basically just working that on the outer corner. That kind of like U-shape that I have in today's eye look was actually unintentional. That's just how it ended up looking on the outer corner. and I kind of just stuck with it. That's why it's not a super crisp line, because that's not what I was going for. It's more of like a diffuse line. But I did go overboard with the shadow a little bit with the orange. So I just took a little bit more of the shade from the Raw Beauty Christie palette and kind of just used it as like an eraser. So the last step that I did for the outer corner is actually go in with that deep brown. So I'm using the shade Chocolate here. And that one is from the Glam Light Ice Cream Dream palette. And that's basically it. I'm going to go in with some liner. This is the Morphe Liquid Liner. This is such a bomb eyeliner. And then I did put on my lashes off camera. So I'll leave the lashes down below so that way you guys can check it out if you're interested. So let's go ahead and move on to the face makeup. For my primer, I'm going to be using my Milk Makeup Hydro Grip Primer. This is one of my favorite primers ever. I use it so often. It is amazing. And we're going to be using a new foundation. We're going to be using the Pat McGrath Labs Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Foundation. Wow, what a name. So the packaging does come all wrapped up, and it does have like a flip up kind of box where you open it up. Super fancy. I love it. And the bottle is bougie, honey. And she's heavy, and she's got a pump. So we love that. I was expecting this foundation to actually be a little thicker than it was, and let me tell you guys, it's more of a liquidy foundation, which I actually don't mind because I have more normal to dry skin. I love this foundation. It is so beautiful. It made my skin look so beautiful, and as you guys can see, I did apply with the Beauty Blender, and the coverage, honey, was still there. I was so impressed. So I did go ahead and use this foundation today, and by the way, the shade that I'm using is the shade Light Medium number 9. So to go ahead and cream bronze, I'm going to be using my Milk Makeup Bronzing Stick. This one is in the shade Baked. I love this stuff. It's amazing. And I'm using it with my Fenty Beauty cream blush bronzer kind of brush. I will leave it down below, like I said. But I went ahead and did that really quickly. And then for concealer, I wanted to use a concealer that I know that I love because I was using a new foundation. This is the Jouer Essential High Coverage Concealer in the shade Cream Cafe. My favorite, okay, concealer ever. If you guys need a good full coverage yet creamy and hydrating concealer, this one is for you. It is so bomb. So now we're gonna jump in to setting powder. You guys, I'm really excited to show you guys the setting powder I'm using. This is the One Size setting powder. You guys, the packaging on this, not even the red box, she's cute, but honey, the cap, you can't even really see it. It's more of like a blush pink cap, and it does have a piece where you can like actually close the powder so it won't seep out as you open the container each time you use it. You guys, this powder is beautiful. I feel so happy because I finally love something from One Size, and I knew Patrick, the queen of setting powder, was not going to let me down. So moving on to bronzer, I'm using this Gucci bronzer. This one I believe is in the shade 03. You guys, the packaging is everything. This was the perfect shade for me. I love it so much. Like, it hurts my heart to say that I love, like, I think a $68 bronzer, but it is so good. I'm obsessed. So shout out to you guys, because a lot of you were like, girl, I picked it up too and I love it. You're going to love it. Girl, I do love it. It is amazing. The color is beautiful. It blended so well. So then I went into this orange blush. This is actually a Jouer blush palette, which I'll leave the name to down below. And I went ahead and popped on some blush. You guys know I love me some blush. And then, of course, one of my favorite parts, which is highlight. I'm going in with the Dior Nude Skin Highlighter in 03. I've been obsessed with this highlighter. Girl, honestly, I've been obsessed with way too many high-end products. Like, I need to chill. But it's a really beautiful highlight. And then I go back in with my blush brush just to make sure everything is nice and blended. So let's move back into finishing up this eye look. So I'm using this Makeup by Mario eye pencil. This is the nude one. You guys, I use this on the other side of my eye. And let me just tell you, this is trash. I don't like it at all. It literally has no pigment to it, and it was pulling on my eyes. So we're gonna go in with my Rimmel Scandal Eyes eyeliner in the shade Nude. This is a $4 eyeliner, and it is the creamiest one I've ever used, and the pigment is amazing. If you guys are looking for a good nude liner, this one is it. So moving back into the shade Coco from the Love Tahiti palette, I'm going to take this on a flat definer brush, and I'm basically just going to smudge that very, very close to my actual lashes. I kind of just wanted to connect the lower lash line with that outer part of the eye, so everything just looks really smoky. So now I'm going to jump into the shade Sundown with almost like a small blending brush, and I'm going to put that right under the shade Coco, of course, make everything look nice and blended and smoky. And then I am going to go into the shade Chocolate from the Glam Light palette, which is what I'm doing here, just to make sure that that lash line looks really nice and intense and smoky. And I feel like putting a dark shade by your lash line just makes it look really pretty and really sultry. So I went ahead and did that really quickly. And then the last shade that I took on the lower lash line is the shade called Yellow. And I took that on that tiny brush and I just diffused the crap out of this. And I actually added a lot of it. So jumping into my Riviera palette, I'm taking the shade Sails and popping that right into the inner corner. The most gorgeous white eyeshadow I have ever seen. It is so pigmented and beautiful. I am obsessed with it. It's gorgeous. So after that inner corner highlight, this look is basically complete. So I took some KKW Beauty mascara and I just put that on my lower lashes. This is my favorite mascara ever. I still have not found another one to compare. And yeah, we're just going to use her to finish up this eye look. So moving into the lips, I did my lips off camera because I use the same combo. This is the KKW Lip Liner in Nude Number 2 and the Lauralee Los Angeles Liquid Lipstick in the shade Nakey Nakey. So that's what I'm wearing on my lips. But girl, let's check out this Artist Couture lip gloss. This is called Uncensored 2.0. This gloss, if you like a glossy moment, you need this lip gloss. It makes your lips look so beautiful and plump, and it has a really nice cooling sensation. I was obsessed. So I went ahead and finished off the look with that gloss. And to make sure everything is nice and sealed, I'm going to go in with the Morphe Luminous Setting Spray. Give myself a good spray down of that. You guys know we love glowy skin. And I'm drying it down with my Batty Bee fan. And honey, that's it. This look is complete. I'm so obsessed with it. Let me know down below what you guys think of this look. I hope you guys had an amazing Thanksgiving. And thank you guys so much for watching. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.